बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास ऑफ मिक्स्ड मेथड रिसर्च एंड आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज मिक्स्ड मेथड्स डेटा एनालिसिस। आई एम डॉक्टर अयाज मोहम्मद खान, डायरेक्टर डिवीजन ऑफ एजुकेशन, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन, लाहौर। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स सी हाउ डू वी प्रोसीड फर्दर। This is the agenda for our today's lecture, mixed method data analysis, thinking about mixed methods data analysis, and then we'll talk about mixed method data analysis strategies and mixed method data analysis exemplars. Dear students, you know that there are fundamental differences between quantitative research and qualitative research methods. You know, for the quantitative research methods, you must have a philosophical paradigm of positivism or post-positivism, where you want to explore reality objectively in numbers. And for that purpose, you go for descriptive statistics and then go for inferential, so that the result which you have got from the sample may be generalized to the whole population. And there is a hell matter of generalization in quantitative studies. But when you look at qualitative researches, they are context based. There is very low generalizability. Their philosophical paradigm may be interpretivism or constructivism. And so far as data collection is concerned, you use entirely different approach from quantitative, where you go for in-depth interviews, observations and document analysis. And then for data analysis, what you do, you go for thematic analysis or developing codes, what you did in grounded theory. So there is a hell of difference between these two strategies and the data collection, data analysis and data interpretation technique. So it means that each of them has got certain strengths and certain weaknesses as well. But there is another way that we are through in PhD class, and that is that both can be used in a single study to adequately address a research problem, meaning thereby at one place you gather the data through sampling, apply descriptive statistics, and then apply inferential to generalize the results of the sample to the whole population using a probability theory, which we usually call a p-value or significant value. And on the other hand, you go for in-depth interviews vertically, get into each minute detail, and ultimately come out of a phenomena that has both plus points, generalizability as well as vertically in-depth analysis. So this is what we call mixed method research designs. As we have already discussed in our previous lectures, that mixed method designs are either sequential design and concurrent. So why am I using again and again this thing? Because our data analysis depends upon the type of design you have chosen. Like you have chosen a sequential design, so we got to see whether it is explanatory or exploratory or sequential transformative design. And if it is concurrent design, then whether concurrent triangulation design or concurrent nested design or concurrent transformative design. So we have to take into account that if we have adopted a mixed method research, then what design have we followed? And our data analysis strategies depend a lot upon the type of research design we have adopted for our research. So let's go through it one by one. Let's talk first of all about the methodological rationale for of mixed method designs. These are 5 points given as a rationale: the triangulation, complementarity, development, expansion, and initiation. Let's discuss it one by one. different question arise in our mind that why do we plan to use both qualitative and quantitative methods in our study? That is what should be in our mind while designing a mixed method study. Then why do we plan to use more than one data collection strategy? Similarly, why do we plan to collect both qualitative and quantitative data? Last but not the least, what are the uses of qualitative and quantitative data or finding for our study? These are the questions that must be kept in mind while conducting mixed method research designs. And triangulation, you know, where you run both the things parallel. Qualitative and quantitative both carry equal weightage. Complementary, where one is assisting the other one. If you have adopted qual, meaning thereby in uppercase, and quan in lower cases, it means that your quantitative research is complementing the qualitative. Same is the other one. So let's see what happens in triangulation. While using different methods to address the same phenomena, seek convergence, corroboration, correspondence of results from the different methods. This rationale is associated with concurrent triangulation design. As I have told you earlier in the previous, what you do that you use both strategies at the same time. You go for gathering quantitative data as well as go for qualitative data. So once you collect the data, you analyze it at the end phase, not at data collection phase. Second is complementary, using different method to address the different parts of the phenomena. Seek elaboration, enhancement, illustration, and clarification of result. What happens that if you have adopted a sequential explanatory design or exploratory design or sequential transformative design, or concurrent nested design or concurrent transformative design. In all those design, what you have to do, especially in the very first three, which are sequential, that you would go for, suppose you have adopted uppercase quan and lowercase quan. So at that phase, first of all, you would get all of your quantitative data, analyze it. After analyzing it, it will give you footprints for your interviews. And once you get through all the interviews, you would write down findings, quantitative findings and qualitative findings separately. But in the end, you would try to compare and contrast both. Same strategy you would use while you have qual as a superior design and quantitative as a inferior. So same case which I have told you in the sequential explanatory or exploratory. Now let's see what is this developmental. Using the result of one method to inform the other method. Seeks to use the results from one method to help develop or inform the other method. In this actually rationale, what you have to keep it in your mind that your further design, as a matter of fact, depends on the findings that you would get on the from the very first type of research you are doing. So you never design suppose you are adopting a quantitative qualitative, quantitative uppercase, qualitative lowercase. So in this matter, you would not mention what would be your qualitative design, because that is what you would develop on the basis of your quantitative findings. Then comes expansion, using different methods to address the different parts of a phenomena. Seek to extend the breadth and range of inquiry. Here, you can go for sequential exploratory, sequential transformative design, concurrent nested design, and concurrent transformative design. Let's talk about initiation. Looking for contradictory result and using different methods to collect data to explain the discrepancy. This is very important. So seek for discovery of paradox and contradiction, new perspective of framework. So once you conduct a research, concurrent nested design or concurrent transformative design, at the end you see what are the contradiction that you have explored out of it. So on the basis of those contradiction, you actually again go and collect data in a different way. Here are some of the important points that show how to determine an appropriate mixed method design. If your mixed method design is sequential explanatory design, it would be better that you go for complementarity design, because it one of your results would ultimately help in exploring the phenomena by either quantitative or qualitative way. Sequential exploratory design, for that developmental design would be far more better, because in exploratory you start with the qualitative and you don't know whether what would happen from the results that you would get, and once you get the result then you think that what sort of design you should go for. Sequential transformative design, it methodological rationale could be complementary as well. In concurrent triangulation would be the method, whereas concurrent nested design, complementarity or initiation and expansion, these methodological rationales would be better. Similarly, in concurrent transformative design, again complementarity, initiation and expansion can be a best choice. Let's see from an example. There is an example, the purpose statement. The purpose of the study is to determine the relationship between mental health, stigma and help seeking behavior among teens with mental health problems in low income neighborhood in Accra, Ghana. In addition, the study will focus on examining how they seek for help to addressing their mental health problems. So your question would be, is there a correlation between mental health stigma and help seeking behavior among teens with mental health problems in a low income neighborhood in Accra, Ghana? So how does teens with mental health problems seek for help or mental health services? So suppose you wish to go for concurrent nested design. I mean QAN first, which would be the major part, and QAL would be your major part. So your theoretical lens is pretty much implicit, hidden within your design. Where would you integrate when you would be interpreting the results? I mean, integrating the result from both could be done at the last stage. So purpose is complementarity, meaning thereby once you go for quantitative data, get results from those quantifications, and from those results you would chalk out your plan what to do. That is why what to do, and it means that your quantitative findings are going to complement your qualitative results. And so far as priority is concerned, you know, unequal, your quantitative data would have more time and space as compared to your qualitative data. Okay, students, let's discuss this chart that shows the type of mixed method designs, the theoretical lens we would use, timing, integration, methodological, rational, and priority. I would request you to look deep into that chart, and while deciding your research proposal, this chart would help you a lot. So let's see, first of all, the sequential explanatory. Here the theoretical lens would be implicit post-positivist lens. You would be using a sequential design where beginning with quantitative phase and then moving to qualitative phase. So when would you integrate your quantitative qualitative data? Data analysis stage, connected and interpretation stage. I mean, while data analysis as well as interpretation, I mean, in data analysis you would make connection between the findings of your quantitative research and qualitative, but here at the interpretation phase you would merge it. methodological rational is complementary, where one is complementing the other. So priority would be for quantitative. But when you go for exploratory, which is sequential exploratory design, you would be using constructivist lens, and that would be very explicit. Then sequential, beginning with qualitative phase, surely in this design qualitative would work well. And then data analysis stage, you would make connection at data analysis stage, and you would merge it at interpretation stage. So methodological, rational, developmental, because once you go for qualitative design, you don't know that at the end what sort of quantitative technique would you use, whether you would go for survey or correlation, or you would go for experimentation, and qualitative data would be on the priority. If it is a sequential transformative design, so lens would be advocacy and would be quite explicit. Sequential, beginning with either quantitative or qualitative, it depends upon you. Data analysis stage, you would connect an interpretation, you would merge it. And this is also complementary or developmental, because if you start with the quantitative, it would be complementary. If you would start with qualitative, it would be developmental. Priority, you either give quantitative or qualitative data, and sometimes you give equal priority to both. Concurrent triangulation, that is where your theoretical lens is implicit. Timing is concurrent, both at the same time, data analysis, separated, and interpretation stage. Initially, data analysis would be separate for quantitative or qualitative, but at interpretation stage, you can merge it. You use triangulation, and both are equal. Concurrent nested design may be implicit or explicit. You can use either implicit design or explicit, and your timing is concurrent. Data analysis actually is data transformed and merged. At data analysis stage, you can make a transformation or merging, but at interpretation stage, merging occurs finally. Complementary initiation is, but it is unequal. One may surpass the other one. This is the difference between concurrent triangulation and concurrent nested design. That in triangulation, both are equal, but in concurrent nested design, both are not equal. Last but not the least is that concurrent transformative design, explicit advocacy lens, meaning thereby constructivist design. Data analysis you do separate, and interpretation you merge the things, and here it can be complementary initiation or expansion, whereas priority is equal or unequal. So you can see that though you have got three concurrent design, but in three concurrent design only in triangulation, both quantitative and qualitative data are equal. But in concurrent nested design, they are unequal. Whereas in concurrent transformative design, as it is explicit, meaning thereby would be more constructivist approach, equal, it can be equal or cannot be equal. This slide, as a matter of fact, tells you, thinking about mixed method data analysis in terms of weightage and description. See, when it is exploratory, qual would be dominant. Smaller quantitative study helps data collection in the principally qualitative study. Exploratory studies are usually qualitative in nature. Using data for a survey to sample individuals for in-depth interviews and exchange. Then if it is quantitative dominant, then smaller quantitative study help guide data collection in a principally quantitative study. When you write quant, it means it would be dominant, and major data would be from that. In explanatory sequential design, if it is qual dominant or quant dominant, you can see how would the things go. Whereas in concurrent, it varies a lot. Dear students, now look at this chart or this picture, and I would request you to write down in one page what you get out of it in terms of approaches, in terms of data collection, in terms of data analysis. Now let's talk about mixed method data analysis exemplars. Mixed method exemplars, the techniques for mixed method data combination and analysis is called as mixed method exemplar. Data combination and analysis techniques are presented using the following approaches: mixed method event analysis, concurrent mixed method analysis for complementarity and completeness, and concurrent nested analysis to provide a broader understanding of phenomena and enrich the description of participant. Okay, dear students, now I would request you to listen to this 3.5 minutes mixed method analysis YouTube video. I have given you the link. Just listen to it and try to correspond what we have learned earlier. Here is a little bit task for you. As you have developed your synopsis and as PhD scholar, you propose mixed method research design for your study. Prepare and report your plan for data analysis. Here I would request you to get deep into your research proposal and the way you would go for your data analysis and data interpretation. So in your research proposal, you would write which design you are going to adopt and then what sort of strategy would you be adopted, what would be the priority area in your research. Dear students, thank you very much for listening to me so patiently. See you again in our next lecture.